Welcome back, dear students. In this revision lecture, we are going to revise dual nature of radiations and matter. Okay. In optics, at the end of optics, we were talking about wave optics. So there we saw interference, diffraction, polarization. These can be explained by using wave nature of light. Okay. Similarly, in this chapter, we will see how polarization, photoelectric effect explains particle nature of light. Okay. Light has wave nature as well as particle nature, dual nature. Similarly, we will see how matter has particle nature as well as wave nature. There is associated wavelength with particles, lambda is equal to h upon mv. We will talk about that. Let's begin with photoelectric effect. सबसे पहले तो बच्चे इसका सेटअप समझते हैं और फिर देखेंगे आइंस्टाइन ने इसको कैसे एक्सप्लेन किया था. व्हाट वाज आइंस्टाइन्स इक्वेशन? इन दिस इवैक्यूएटेड ट्यूब We are allowing through this lens light to fall. Okay, light is coming. Now here light is behaving like particles. Okay, photons of light. Photons have energy E is equal to h mu. Mu is the frequency of light. Okay, photons have energy E is equal to h mu. This light falls on this photosensitive metal. Okay, photosensitive metal. Okay, and if you remember, metal has electrons, and those electrons are readily able to come out of metal. Okay, so but still they need some energy to come out of metal. Okay, here electrons need phi naught energy to come out, at least phi naught. Okay, even if you are giving more than phi naught, they will accept that, but they need at least phi naught energy to come out of metal. This phi naught is called work function of metal. Work function of metal. It depends on metal. Okay, different metal have different work function. Now this energy can be compared with this energy by writing phi naught is equal to h mu naught. Phi naught is equal to h mu naught. Here mu naught becomes a threshold frequency or minimum frequency for electron to come out. Okay, for electron emission, minimum frequency of light for electron emission. Okay, because at least it needs this much energy, which means photon should have at least this much frequency so that it comes out. This is called a threshold frequency. Now if this has more energy than phi naught, then Einstein gave equation that out of this energy h mu, if phi naught is used in the electron's energy to come out, then remaining energy becomes kinetic energy of electron. Okay, since this is minimum energy, at least energy is this much, so this is maximum kinetic energy possible of electrons. Okay, since you know all the electrons do not need same amount of energy, the outermost electron needs minimum energy, then the electrons from inner shells, they need more energy. So this is the maximum possible energy, total energy of photon minus work function. Okay, other expressions of writing this are h mu minus h mu naught is equal to kinetic energy maximum of electrons. Okay, remaining energy becomes kinetic energy of electrons. Okay, remaining energy becomes kinetic energy of electrons. Okay, now we can apply a potential to accelerate or stop them. Okay, we can apply some potential. let's say V. If I'm applying negative potential this side, negative, then these negative charged electrons, they will be slowed down. And if I'm applying sufficient potential, they can be stopped. Okay, in that case, kinetic energy becomes charge of electron into stopping potential. Okay, V naught is stopping potential. V naught is stopping potential. So stopping potential depends on frequency of light, it depends on metal, but it does not depend on how many number of photons are coming. Okay, now that is a very important point to understand. Intensity of light means number of photons which are coming. If I'm increasing the intensity, or if I'm increasing the brightness of light, I'm increasing number of photons. For example, if there is a red light of less brightness, or red light of very large, very huge amount of intensity, then the difference between them is not of frequency. Okay, their photons are having exactly same energy, but number of photons are more when brightness is more. Okay, so if I'm increasing the brightness, energy of each photon is still h mu, but number of photons are increasing, so more number of electrons will come out, but they will still have same energy. So stopping potential is not going to depend on number of photons which are coming or intensity of light which is coming. So let's see the factors which are going to affect photoelectric effect. Usually question bache graphs pe hi aayega, un factors pe hi aayega. Graph number 1 is for current and intensity of light. Okay, so if I'm in increasing intensity of light, I am simply increasing number of photons. Number of photons. But energy of each photon is still same. Energy of each photon is same. H mu. Okay, so I have not increased the energy of photon. I have just increased number of photons by increasing intensity. Now if intensity will be more electrons, more number of photons will come and hit that metal, more electrons will come out. So accordingly current will keep on increasing in straight line. Okay, as intensity increases, number of photons increases, number of electrons emitted increases. Okay, since number of electrons increases, photoelectric current increases. Okay, so this is simple relation between them, but this is only possible if frequency of light is greater than threshold frequency. Okay, because if frequency of light is less than threshold frequency, then no matter how much intensity we increase, the current remains zero. Okay, if frequency of light is less, if this is less, kinetic energy will become negative. Okay, if mu is less than mu naught, kinetic energy will become negative. Negative kinetic energy is not possible, so this is not possible. Current will simply remain zero. In this case, photons will not even be absorbed by metal. Graph number 2 is graph between current and potential. Now, potential can be positive as or negative. If you remember that collector plate, if it is positive charged, electrons will be accelerated toward it. Okay, so current will increase. But if it is negatively charged, then electrons will be repelled and they will slow or eventually even stop. So potential positive will increase the current, potential negative will slow down the electrons and it will decrease the current. Even if there is no potential, let's say is plate pe koi potential diya hi nahi, electrons have some kinetic energy, so they will move without potential. They have kinetic energy, they will complete the circuit without external potential. So even if potential is zero, there is current. As potential becomes positive, electrons are accelerated. Okay, as current voltage is negative, electrons are retarded, and at some potential they can even stop. This is called stopping potential. Now we know that kinetic energy of electrons is equal to charge into stopping potential, which is also equal to h mu minus h mu naught, which means stopping potential depends on frequency of light. Stopping potential depends on frequency of light, and it depends on work function, or I can say, and it depends on metal. Okay, it depends on this threshold frequency, or I can say it depends on metal. It does not depend on intensity of light. Does not depend on intensity of light. Now, when we increase intensity of light, if you remember, we are increasing number of photons, but their energy is not increased, just their number is increased. So by increasing the number of photons, we are increasing number of electrons, current will change. Okay, if I will use intensity I2 greater than I1, current is going to increase in that case. In case of I2, current will be more, but stopping potential does not depend on intensity of light as long as frequency is same. Okay, what is going to change is eventually the current, which becomes constant, saturation current. Saturation current depends on intensity of light. ओके, क्वेश्चंस ग्राफ से भी पूछे जा सकते हैं, क्वेश्चंस इन कॉन्सेप्ट्स इन पॉइंट्स के भी अराउंड पूछे जा सकते हैं कि कौन सा फैक्टर किस चीज को इफेक्ट करता है. ओके, एज इन दिस ग्राफ वी केप्ट फ्रीक्वेंसी सेम एंड वी वेरीड इंटेंसिटी. देयर इज ग्राफ नंबर 3 इन व्हिच वी कीप द इंटेंसिटी कांस्टेंट एंड वी चेंज द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ लाइट. इफ इंस्टेड ऑफ ब्लू लाइट वी आर यूजिंग अ रेड लाइट, व्हाट हैपेंस टू द फोटोइलेक्ट्रिक इफेक्ट, लेट्स सी. Now this is the graph for different frequencies, intensity same. Okay, saturation current depends on intensity of light, so both of them, since they are having same intensity, the saturation current is same. Stopping potential does not depend on intensity of light. Okay, but still here it is, if I am keeping intensity constant, stopping potential comes out to be different because it does not depend on intensity, it depends on frequency of light. Okay, it depends on frequency of light and on metal. So in this case, I have used two different lights. If frequency of light is more, eventually electrons will gain more kinetic energy. Okay, if frequency is more, they will gain more kinetic energy, and stopping potential has to be more in negative direction. So here I can see, since V naught is more, it means mu 1 must have been greater than mu 2. Okay, जब frequency ज़्यादा होगी तो light के पास जो energy है वो ज़्यादा होगी, तो उससे electrons को जो kinetic energy मिलेगी वो ज़्यादा होगी, तो उनको रोकने के लिए जो stopping potential होगा वो भी ज्यादा लगाना पड़ेगा. इन नेगेटिव डायरेक्शन मोर स्टॉपिंग पोटेंशियल बिकॉज म्यू 1 इज ग्रेटर देन म्यू 2. ओके, ऑल दोस पॉइंट्स आर स्टिल सेम. लेट्स सी ग्राफ नंबर 4. ग्राफ नंबर 4 इज बिटवीन दिस स्टॉपिंग पोटेंशियल एंड फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ लाइट. ओके, स्टॉपिंग पोटेंशियल वर्सेस फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ लाइट. Now, as we have just discussed in previous graph, that stopping potential is going to depend on frequency, what is the relation between them? let's say I want to make easy relation between stopping potential and frequency y x. So let me simplify these terms. I can say mu naught is equal to h by e into mu minus h mu naught by e. H mu naught by e. So if I am comparing it with y is equal to mx plus c, slope of the graph, this must be straight line graph, okay, straight line graph with slope being positive and y intercept being negative. So there will be imaginary negative y intercept and slope will be positive, okay. Slope is equal to tan theta and that slope is equal to h by e. It does not depend on any metal. This slope is going to be same for any metal, but this h by e mu naught y intercept is going to depend on metal. Okay, let's say there are two different metals, y intercept, or let's see when this stopping potential is going to be zero. It will be zero when mu and mu naught they are equal. Okay, when mu becomes equal to mu naught, let's say mu naught 1, mu naught 2. Okay, since threshold frequency is different, stopping potential will become zero when mu is equal to mu naught. Okay, cutoff frequency of metal 1 and of metal 2. It has a different cutoff frequency. It has different cutoff frequency. Accordingly, this point and y intercept will become different, but slope will be same for both of them, h by e. From here I can even tell which of these metals have more work function. Since this has more frequency, its work function is more. Work function of 1 is greater than work function of 2 because mu naught 1 is greater than mu naught of 2. Okay, now simple concept based questions can be asked on this graph. Okay, ये तो बात हो गई बच्चे के radiations के पास dual nature कैसे है, और उनके पास wave nature भी था. अब हमें समझ में आ गया कि उनके पास particle nature भी है through photoelectric effect. Okay, now let's see how matter has wave nature as well as particle nature. Matter, let's say this is a ball. Okay, it has mass m, so it is a particle. It must have particle nature. Particle nature. It has mass. It has volume. Okay. It has momentum. Kinetic energy. So and so. These all properties are because it is having particle nature. Now, there was this. Hypothesis of de Broglie. De Broglie said that if radiations have a particle nature, then particles should also have a dual nature as radiations. He said that particles should also have wavelength. De Broglie's wavelength lambda is equal to h upon mv, h by momentum of the particle, okay, which is equal to h divided by momentum, can be written as 2 times mass into kinetic energy. Okay, kinetic energy can also be replaced. If it is a charged particle, we can replace kinetic energy as charge into potential, accelerating potential or stopping potential. Okay, we know that kinetic energy is charge into potential. So this is basic concept of de Broglie. Lambda is equal to h by p or h by mv. Further are the expressions according to our necessity in terms of kinetic energy or in terms of potential. For example, here there is special result for wavelength of electron accelerated through potential V. Accelerated through potential V. Now H is constant, 2 is constant, the mass of electron, charge of electron, these all are constant. So if we will fill all these values, it becomes 1.227 nanometers divided by under root V. Okay, so this is special result of nothing but de Broglie's wavelength. Okay, if electron is accelerated through potential V, it moves in form of wave. Okay, electron is forming waves. Okay, electron wavelength is 1.227 nanometers divided by under root V. Why this wave nature of particles is not visible, is not practically observed? Because value of H is very small, 6.6 into 10 is power minus 34. Okay, its units are joules, joules second. Okay, joules second. Now, since this is very small, since value of H is very small, value of lambda for particles is negligible. So generally we can neglect their wave nature. Generally we can neglect wave nature of particles, because wavelength is very small. If I'm filling the mass of a body of mass 1 kg moving at 1 meter per second, okay, 1 kg 1 meter per second will give me wavelength 6.6 into 10 raised power minus 34 meters. Okay, now that wavelength is so small, okay, that we can simply neglect that wavelength. We can simply, usually we can neglect particle nature, usually we can neglect wave nature, but not always. For example, in case of electrons, their wave nature is significant. एक और यहाँ पे बहुत ही इम्पोर्टेंट यहाँ पे प्रिंसिपल है, हाइजेनबर्ग अनसर्टेनिटी प्रिंसिपल. Now this is also very very important. Why? Because he said that delta x dot delta p should is approximately equal to this, approximately equal to h by 2 pi, okay, which should be greater than h by 4 pi. It should be greater than or equal to h by 4 pi, or it is approximately equal to h by 2 pi. Okay, now this law says that Heisenberg's uncertainty principle says that we cannot find exact position and exact position and exact momentum of electron simultaneously. Okay, we cannot find exact position and exact momentum of electron simultaneously. If a position is known accurately, if position is known accurately, delta x becomes zero. Okay, if delta x will become zero, delta p will become h by 4 pi into zero. So delta p will become infinite, it will tend to infinite. So error becomes very large. And if momentum is known accurately, delta p becomes zero. In that case, delta x tends to infinity. This is also very important principle in a dual nature of radiations and matter. But that is it.